Hello, and we're thankful that you're all here tonight. I'm going to introduce a board member in a minute who will introduce you to everyone else. But I first wanted to call your attention to some lists that we have out at the desk. If you're interested in being on our mailing list, please fill it out, an emailing list. We can save a fortune in postage the more people we do that. And we promise it's not going to be a pitch for money. It's to keep you informed of what's going on at the Family Center. So please sign up if you're willing to. I'll call your attention to all the raffle items we have here. And there are sponsor signs over in the corner to recognize the people who have done so much to help us out tonight. And our primary sponsor is Fred Fontaine for The Perfect Place, which is where we are, obviously. And we're very grateful to Fred for donating this space. And Robert's Jewelry of Canton is one of our major sponsors. And State Representatives Claire Cronin and Jerry Cassidy were the first to jump on the bandwagon and buy sponsorships for us, so we appreciate that. And now I don't have the list in front of me, and I'm going to forget everyone else, so forgive me, but I'll direct you to the signs when we're done. So now I'd like to introduce Ann Dabrowski, who will introduce the board members of the Family Center. And as she calls your name, could you just come up so everyone can see who you are in case they have questions they want to ask you later?
Good evening. Our board members, including myself, are the original Linda, Julie Kennard, Linda Kenny Logan, and Donna Migdale. It was all started of a afternoon with friends and saying we really needed to do something for Michelle. From there, it has grown. Our newest members, Nancy Asmutis, who's a local activist. She's been with us implementing local events prior to being elected to the board. She was the first parent liaison at Raymond School. Nancy Tucker, who joined the board in July. She's a niece of Michelle. We like to keep it family. And she's been following the center since its inception. She's employed by the Brockton School Department at Brockton High School. Mary Lou Piantoni Best, also. She's a longtime Girl Scout leader and co-leader with Nancy. She's been a longtime volunteer in the city. Russell. He is the son of Michelle Sasso Logan, and poor kid's been with us since he was four. He is a proud product of the Brockton School Department. He's a graduate of UMass Dartmouth and is presently employed by Brown Brothers Hartman and Company. Yvonne Burdett is one of our recent additions to the board. She is extremely active in the community. She's employed by State Street Corporation for over 30 years and is also the recipient of the Girl Scout Appreciation Pin. Carla is our newest member, Carla Fernandez. She has participated in the planning and the implementation of the Family Center events for many years. She is currently the building-wide MTA, Monitor Teacher Assistant, for the Raymond School. We are very pleased to have our newest members with us. May they enjoy their time with us as much as we have. Thank you so much.
See, and none of them will obey willy-nilly. They didn't want to get up, so they just sat there, so that's okay. And now I would like to introduce Donna Migdale, who will start the story.
Always do what I'm told. I want to thank Linda. I want to thank Anne. Julie Kennard isn't with us tonight because nicely, she's retired and hanging out in Florida, where the retired people go. We were the original board members of the Michelle A. Logan Family Center. There was nobody who was more inclusive than Michelle Logan and Charlie. We have to drag Charlie into this too, because he was pretty much part of the beginning also. When my son started at the Raymond School, I went to a PAC meeting. Michelle was the president of the PAC, I think, or the treasurer?
She did them all, I don't know.
She did everything. But anyway, went to my first PAC meeting, met the ladies that were there. The next day, my phone is ringing. It's Michelle. How would you like to go out to lunch? Fine by me. Met for lunch. Instant friendship. That was Michelle. She was instant friendship. She was inclusive. She had great ideas of doing activities. When she passed away, it made a giant hole in our community of sisterhood. The girls that were PAC ladies were lost. And in order to fill that hole, Linda came up with an idea of dedicating a space at the Raymond School that would personify Michelle and her contributions, not only to the Raymond School, but to the North community and Brockton at large. It was a beautiful idea. We had a lot of help from the school department in order to get the space requisitioned. We raised money to have it latticed, which was part of Michelle's style of decoration. And we were very pleased when, a few years down the road, after the dedication, parent liaisons were hired at Brockton Public Schools to work with parents and families. So our parent liaisons worked out of that space at the Raymond School. We did a lot of cultural programs. We did a lot of things with families, math nights, and the liaisons were instrumental in helping us get the families involved at the Raymond School, get them any kind of help they might have needed moving into the Raymond School or moving about the school system. We're very pleased that after 20 years, we have a vibrant board, a young board, to come and help perpetuate what is done at the Raymond School. I don't know where Carol is. Carol, we love you, and we know that you work hard for the students and the families every single day, and it means a lot to us that we old folks can step back and the young board can work with you and keep things going. And I thank you all for coming. Your contributions are more than we could ever have asked for, and we're very appreciative. Enjoy your dinner, and please enjoy the raffle. Thank you.
Yikes! I'll go this way.
We will have no ambulances tonight, I'm sorry. So what is a family center? We were the first ones in Brockton, and the idea has come up in other places, but it's physically a place. There is a room at the Raymond School. It's not gigantic, but it's ours. Parents can come in there and use our computers or borrow parenting information if they would like to do so. But our major focus has been programming. So it can be how-to things like car seat safety, how to navigate the system for parents of children with special needs, fun things, lots of game nights, enrichment activities, math and science night, or mathletics, or sports reading, just to complement the curriculum for the kids. But one of the things that is the prime focus of this fundraiser is to raise money for our personal grants that we give to parents of the school. And it's all, anonymous through the guidance department, houses that burn down or people who need groceries or school uniforms at holiday time, making baskets. And it's all done through guidance, but we need more bucks. You know, we don't have a big cash reserve to continue to do this. So that was one of our goals for having the fundraiser, is to do that kind of a program. So we appreciate you being here so much. I've been remiss. I'd like to introduce some dignitaries who are here tonight. I'm going to do Mark Lindy first because I know he has to sneak out very quickly. Our cameraman here, Mark Lindy from Brockton Cable Access, is a great friend of the family center. We have representatives, Jerry Cassidy, on the back there, one of our sponsors, Claire Cronin, state representative, and state representative Michelle Dubois. And we appreciate you being here very much. Jerry, would you like to come up?
I also want to say, Russell, you're very lucky. You're going out with Sarah Dunsing, who is a family friend. And that's, I know I'm embarrassing Sarah right now, but that's quite all right, Sarah. Oh, she's turning red. Anyway, I work with Charlie Logan. And Charlie was on the city council. We had a wonderful time on the city council. He was just a great man. We do have a couple citations. One here is from the state senate. And I'm just going to read that. It says, you need my glasses.
You're supposed to take care of me.
I didn't always have to wear glasses. The state senate official citation, be it known that Mass State Senate hereby extends the congratulations to Michelle Logan Family Center in recognition of the celebration of your 25th year of providing programming and services for the Raymond School. And signed by Harry Chandler, the Senate President, State Senator Mike Brady, and William Welch, the clerk. That's for you.
Good evening. It's very nice to be here with you tonight. My sister was a longtime teacher at the Raymond School, so I know what a great place that the Michelle Logan Family Center is. So, on behalf of the House of Representatives, be it hereby known to all that the Mass House of Representatives offers its sincerest congratulations to the Michelle A. Logan Family Center in recognition of your 20th anniversary of commitment and services to support the children and families of the Raymond School community. And the entire membership extends its very best wishes and expresses the hope for future good fortune and endeavors. And it is signed by our colleague, State Representative Michelle Dubois, Representative Cassidy, myself, and also the Speaker of the House, Robert DeLeo. So, congratulations.
Have the pleasure of introducing our fearless leader, Carol McGrath, principal of the Raymond School. And she doesn't even yell at us too much.
Never, never, ever. I won't take long, just very, very proud and so happy to be here to represent the Raymond School. And I want to share just some of the amazing impact that the Logan Center has had on the Raymond School over the last that I've been there 13 years, and I know it goes back 20 years, but this is my 13th year at the Raymond School. And as you know, most of you that had children at the Raymond, the demographics of the Raymond School has changed over the last few years. But be that as it may, we know how important it is for families to be involved with their children. And with the Logan Center being so generous and offering so many activities, we're able to provide these wonderful family activities for our students and families at no cost. So Linda, the board members, current, former, founding, just thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. I just can't thank you enough for all the hours of joy and pleasure you have brought to the families of the Raymond School. And please join me in thanking Linda, because she is the catalyst behind everything that goes on with the Logan Center. So Linda, can we just give Linda a clap? She's amazing, so generous. Your kind and generous spirit, it's inspirational. So thank you, Linda. Thank you, everyone, and enjoy your night.
Now I'd like to introduce Russell Logan, one of our board members, who is going to talk about the center from the perspective of the family.
Hi, everybody. First, I'd like to thank you so much for being here tonight. I know with rescheduling and everything, it was really difficult for everybody to make it. So I just want to say that we're extremely thankful for everybody being here. And it's, I hope we have a great time. It's helping us in so many ways. When I think of the center, it's the first thing that comes to my mind is the family photo of my mom, my dad, my brother, and me that's hanging outside of the center. It's crazy to me to think that it's been there for 20 years now, and it's humbling in a way because I know how important it is and how much of an impact we have on the school with a lot of what we do. And most of my favorite things about the Raymond School do revolve around the Family Center and the things that we were able to bring to the community. Just a few are the multicultural nights that we would hold. I love them so much. Students and their families would bring in different staples of their cuisine and different family culture, family traditions and things like that. And I think being such a diverse community, it's a really important thing for the school and for the students and their families. Another one of the things that I've really enjoyed, or I did enjoy and I will enjoy when we bring them back, are the drumming groups that we brought. I think one of them was named Kakate, we've had a few others. It turned into this thing for me that I loved music, and it turned into something that I carried throughout my high school career and into college, and I still do love playing every now and then whenever I get the chance. Yeah, I mean, a lot of what I want to do is bring back the same things that I enjoyed so much when I was in school and participating in all the events that we would hold. Thank you again for being here. Before I hand this over to Mary Lou, I just want to introduce a few members of my family who are able to join us tonight. My brother Jeff and my nephew Giovanni and his mom Krista. On my mom's side, a few of my aunts and uncles, my Aunt Ro and Uncle Joe, Debbie and Brian, and Joanne and John. And again, I would like to introduce the chairwoman, Mary Lou.
I just want to take a moment and thank everyone for coming out tonight to celebrate the 20th anniversary of the Michelle Logan Center, located at the Raymond School. The money we raise tonight, we will be able to make more activities for the Raymond families. It's been a privilege to be the chairwoman of this board. I have learned a lot about Michelle through her friends, her son Russell, and her niece Tucker. The Family Center would not be possible without the consistent support of Carol McGrath. Carol has gone above and beyond to support the center for the last 13 years. Thank you, Carol, for all you have done. Carol, could you please come up, please? Tonight's event has been a vision of Linda Logan's for many years. Linda has worked hard and spent many hours planning tonight's gala. Thank you, Linda, for your dedication to the center and for all that you do for the Raymond families. Could you please come up?